I wanted to talk a little bit about my process. I always say that look who visited me today. And I honestly feel that way because I start off with an abstract. You know, I'll take, this is some of my favorite stuff. It's a Creative Color charcoal powder. I really like the, there's doesn't seem to be any big chunks and stuff like that in it. So I really enjoy this. And then I just take several different brushes. The black one's probably my favorite. It's soft. You can see the charcoal just poofed out from that. And then I go in with it. So I lay it down with a big brush and I go in with a smaller brush and I start pushing things around until I create an abstract, some shapes where I can see some shapes in there. And that's where I start. I have a different video that just covers that itself. If you want to go back and take a look, you can. And I have a heater going on because it's cold here. So if you can hear that, I apologize. That little drone going on. But anyhow, I wanted to show these because this is how I start. And what I'm looking for is a face, is a character, somebody who wants to come out. And I love this process because I feel, at least for me, that my imagination without something pushing it forward or something for it to work with is never as creative as looking at shapes and letting my mind kind of wander and fill in shapes. And you can direct this process. This process just isn't random. Like right now I'm working on a Krampus series. It's December and I wanted to kind of explore what I think Krampus's world could look like. And so I put stuff down in my head. I'm thinking about Krampus and I'm thinking about what characters and the antlers and horns and pointy ears and teeth and, you know, so I'm thinking of all those stuff. And so by thinking of it, I'm going to naturally, it's going to show up in my imagination and I'm going to transfer that thought pattern into what I'm seeing. So it can be controlled as well. And this month I am doing a little bit of that controlling, but also only controlling it a wee bit. So like a 5-10%, and I'm letting the rest just happen. And so this is how I start. And so you can see all sorts of really interesting shapes and a lot of, you can see a face right here. You can see a face right here. I mean, and these can turn in angles and looking up, you can almost see a horn going through here and, you know, just an arm here, maybe an arm here. There's just so much going on in this particular one that it'll take a while. So I'll do 4, 5, 6 of these, if not more, and I'll just leave them all around my studio and until I see a face come out. And you know, just lately I did a whole bunch and then like it seemed like all at once all these faces came out. So I have this one that's just a random one and I can see faces already. I have this one going on right now and I haven't really looked hard enough at this one to see if I see anything yet. I tend, and I do this often, this shape of a little bit bigger. It's almost like a light bulb. It's bigger and it goes down a little smaller. There's something about that shape that I like and I've really been playing with it. And you can see all this push. I let it be messy. So when I'm putting this down and the charcoal's getting heavy and thick, I blow it off and I let that just fluff off. It's okay. I don't care. I like this messiness. I'm not trying to control it. I'm just letting it be what it's going to be. But I am looking for a face. Very rarely do I hit a thing and see an arm and then work from an arm. Normally it's a face. And so, like I said, I hit several kind of all in a row. And I'm going to show you some of these here. I'm just going to put these three out like this. And so these three hit almost all at once. Can't see the other one, but I'll pull it down here. I don't want to cover, so. But you can see here, I saw this face. And I saw this horn, you know, and I went, the horn came from was because it's going to, I want to keep it Krampus. So I want to keep it this kind of antler horn type thing. I knew that. And so, but I saw this face and I really liked the angle of this face. I liked it. I'm going to put some teeth in there, but I really liked it. So that's where I'm going to start. And now my imagination is still got a fill in all this. And I can go outside of the box, if you will. I can keep it within it. I don't know exactly what I see in this one yet beyond this, but I know I really am liking him and as a character. And so I will sit on this for a little while and just keep working on this. I'll probably get the horns in a lot like the ear where it's darker and then it kind of goes to a bit lighter like I've been doing a lot of my other horns. And so I will start working on this slowly, but I'll let it sit until I see something in the rest of this. And that's why I work on so many pieces at once, is that I don't force them. I do my best to not force them. I let them just kind of grow and come out. And so I got this one. This guy came out and I thought, oh, he's really interesting. But I tried to erase him because I felt like he was too normal. You know, normally my faces are a little bit more stylistic and stuff. And I thought, he's too normal. So I actually went back in with charcoal. I put more charcoal over the top of it. I tried to scrub it out with a brush. And he just stayed. I couldn't get rid of him. And so I thought, well, if I can't get rid of him, I need to explore it. And so I did. And now I'm really enjoying how he's coming out. As a matter of fact, I was talking to a friend, Jaime, just the other last night, as a matter of fact, and he was talking about Crazy Horse and that no pictures were ever taken of Crazy Horse. And so he's done several paintings of what he envisions Crazy Horse to look like. So I showed him this and he goes, that would work, you know. And it does have a little bit of an Indian feel to it with some paint on it. But I have him, you know, an ear, because for me, I'm still thinking Krampus, right? And I don't know where he sits in the Krampus world, but I will find a place for him. But I do find it very interesting. I like the horns. I'm not even sure what I'm going to do with this big old piece coming out of the top of his head, if it's an ornamentation or something like that. But these will probably be feathers here, kind of thing. But that's how I started. The face just kind of came, and I'll figure it out. And then this one also, it was the same thing, where this face showed up, and I just followed it. And it's going to have kind of this big horn thing coming around. And you can see this. There's the elbow, the tricep, the shoulder kind of coming out here. So there's going to be a hand. The hand's kind of going to kind of go in like this, like it's kind of crinked in like that. And then I'm not 100% sure what I'm going to do like this, but it almost looks like a frog kind of thing. I don't know, but I'll just keep working it. You know, I saw the arm, so I'll work the arm. And through working the arm, the horn and the rest of it will start to take place. You can kind of see it almost like here's the rear end and an arm, a kind of a leg going out, maybe going in, and here's some feet kind of just sticking out kind of thing. Almost like he's sitting like a dog or something like that, or a frog, like I said. But you can see now, you know, to make the head, the face pop, I'm starting to add darks here. And so what I do is, if my imagination gets stuck, I revert back to what I know I'm going to want to do. The basics of drawing, where you want to put light and dark together, where you want to direct the eye. And you start doing that work, and then your mind just kind of gets into that, and next thing you know, your imagination starts flowing, and the rest of the piece starts to fill in. So anyhow, there's three. The one I'm currently really kind of going after, because I can see a lot of it, is this one here. I am really, really enjoying this piece. And it's not completely filled in, but it's filling in. And you can see that you know, it's kind of this Santa, you know, like around the Santa hat and around the Santa neck collar, you know, this kind of fluffy white, you know, so this is obviously going to be some sort of fabric that's flowing, maybe possibly over his leg here. And then he's got this big emblem, and how I'm starting to think of him as, it's almost like he's not a reindeer, but he does pull, let's say, a sled or something like that. And so I think I'm going to do some cables and another round piece here, maybe, and maybe a cable kind of going off here, and maybe do something like it's lashed to it or something like that. Like he's pulling something, you know. He also kind of got these horn wing things that are coming off that I'm going to definitely play into. Yeah, I'm not sure what I'm going to do with all this back here, but it'll come to me. You know, it might just be, you know, as you've seen in some of my other pieces, it might be just that I just give him this kind of arched back that you see here and kind of use my paintbrush to remove some of that kind of deal, almost making it like smoke or just like it is here. Just, it's just shapes that's there. And I think I'm going to, you know, do some nice folds in the fabric. You can kind of see them there. They're already there almost, right? And even if one goes over the back of his leg here, you know what I mean? Like the fabric's kind of going in and folding over his leg kind of deal, you know what I mean? And then I think I'm going to give the fabric some sort of designs. Like I love the curly Q designs, you know, I'll probably give that whole fabric a design, you know? So if I was picturing it red or something over the top with gold piece, and you can kind of see he's got this kind of cool chin hair going on and this crazy hair with almost these like antenna like things that I'm gonna stick with. I'm gonna keep going with it. But that's where, you know, the imagination comes in. Is like, I probably wouldn't have thought of this kind of antenna with this feathery fluffy top onto it, but it's there. Even this one is farther in the background, it's there, right? So I'm gonna follow that, you know. And I probably wouldn't have thought of this shape and the way the neck's kind of kicking out. It's almost just this bizarre hunched back thing, you know what I mean? And this arm's kind of coming in and moving through. As a matter of fact, this even could be the shape of the arm underneath the fabric. And then I could actually shape the fabric to that. And it could be like this crazy big arm in there, you know what I mean? Or crazy thin. Oh, it's pretty big actually, you know? So you can see that you can just keep going on these pieces. But I just wanted to kind of give it an overview of what I think and how I work. Is these guys just kind of come to me. I do feel like they visited. So anyhow, I think I'm going to leave it at that. I was going to draw on this for a little bit and kind of film it, and maybe I will do that and post it on a different video. But I think for now, what I really wanted to get across is a little bit of how I work and what I'm thinking as I'm working. And a lot of times I'm not thinking very much. If I'm thinking anything, I'm trying to direct it like I am with Krampus and this project. And that's about it. After that, I'm just letting go. I'm just letting the guys kind of show up. And I definitely have throughout all my stuff, even though it's just an abstract, my voice still comes through because my imagination sees things in very specific ways. Like you'll always see, it seems like horns, big ears, these crazy noses, this kind of poofed out mouth section here. You'll see in a lot of my drawings. But I let the imagination go, you know, and I don't know. Like here, this one doesn't have a lot of the big nosy stuff like that, but it has the big old horns on it. Right. So, and I had no idea who that was going to be. This piece here was actually going to be something completely different. I actually, when I first did this, I thought, oh, I see it right away. And it was going to be this almost horse skull, and it had these shoulders, and these were going to be the arms that were coming down. They're going to be super thin and bony. And this was going to be the rib cage and the body, the kind of the spine section coming out with things dripping from it. I was like, oh, this is going to be the greatest thing. I let it sit for like almost 2 weeks. And then I sit down to start drawing on it. And he comes out. And I've heard, it's almost like, you know, honey, I'm home. You know, The Shining is kind of what he looks like, right? But I just went with it. Even though I really wanted to do the other thing, he's who decided needed to come out. So I just let him come out. I just drew it. Said, okay, well, I'll just explore this and let the other idea go, not be attached to it. So anyhow, I think I'm going to go ahead and call it good. But thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Hit like if you can. Subscribe would be great. I try to do these videos as often as I can. And like I said, I think the next one is going to be a process one, at least a little bit of a process one. I don't know if I want to do a time lapse or if I really want to do just snippets of me drawing and how I handle laying down the charcoal in these areas because it is a process. So I think I might just cover that process actually. So, and yeah, I think I said so enough. Take care. Thanks for watching. Bye.